Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Betrayal at Krondor, brought to you by Jason. As per usual, we're just jumping on in here, and ideally, oh my god, there's more of them! Ideally, we'll be able to make it to a town without getting just completely torn apart by hordes of roving assassins, but it would appear that the path we are taking is beset on all sides. Insert Samuel L. Jackson quote about the path of the righteous man. Ideally, this isn't gonna be too much trouble. But here, let me pull up the map really quick. Now, what I want to do is head down to Hawk's Hollow because I think, God, where were we? We were going. We want to get to Krondor, which is way the hell down here. So yeah, Hawk's Hollow is, I guess, on the way. I wonder what the difference, like, I don't know what the difference is between, like, maybe these are the menu towns, the white ones are menu towns, and all the other ones are just small ones, but it does look like we were coming up on a town, L'Oreal. I do like that it, from what it appears, like, I can just kind of wander wherever I want in this whole region. I'm curious as to whether or not this is the only region in the game. I'm going to go ahead and hazard a guess that it's probably not. Luckily, we struggle to make sense of it all, as the enemy advances kind of, yeah, alright, so just standard combat text there. Alright, how are we looking? Can I look at everybody's stats? Yes, 7, 10, and 17. So Gorath is in the best shape of all of us. We need to rest, though, pretty badly. Oh, seriously, looking at your stats. Oh my god. Stab him. Go for him. Alright, you run over here. You swing. Haha. Alright, and from what I understand, well, from what the manual says, I believe skill gain in this, like, this is not a level-based game. So skill gain is all based on use. So that's why, like, I'm having Locklear here swing and so on. Because every time you hit, you know, stats are going up. Alright, you can defend. And what we're gonna do after this fight is probably rest until healed. Alright, so now we gotta stun this guy again. I have enough stamina to pop this guy 4 more times, which is 8 more rounds of combat, and ideally we will not need those 8 rounds if my guys would start hitting. Oh! He attacked. Oh man, Owen comes out with a clutch strike to the groin with his staff and drops the guy. Impressive. I didn't know that they could resist this. Alright. It's not gonna keep me from spamming it, but I'll have to keep that in mind. There we go. Alright. Alright. Come on. Grass accuracy melee has increased. See, there you go. It's amazing. Oh, and look for supplies. Feeling a bit like a vulture. I'll take that. Let's see, 83 condition sword. Go ahead and drop this one. See, what I'm gonna start doing now is it's the gear shuffle. They have higher quality gear, and I assume that the higher the quality is, the more it's gonna sell for. So, you know, if I can shuffle it out for, you know, nicer stuff, I will. Okay, share those with the party. Assuming that was not, like, shitty spoiled rations. No, they were not, apparently. Because you got 15 days on you, and he's got 13. Awesome. Alright, now against all common sense, we're just gonna kinda nap here. Camp until healed. Oh yeah, that was a couple days. And I'm gonna rest until morning. Alright, everybody's back in tip-top shape, ready to do violence upon the world and continue poking around. Okay, so what I wanna do is pull this up, and I wanna look around for town names. And the reason I'm looking around for town names is that Dwarf mentioned that there was the one town had a problem with some monster in the mines. I think that might have been Sarsargoth. We'll maybe putter along back there and see. Den camp on the teeth. Alright. Held point. I don't know. I'm not gonna worry about it too much right now though. Oh, it looks like there's something up here though. I would never have even noticed whatever this is. Oh, okay, is that a temple? Incense swirled. Striding between the columns of the temple, Locklear made for the heavy wooden doors which had been sealed against the daylight and which preserved the privacy of any ceremonies in progress. Pulling a tasseled rope which hung next to the door, he awaited the response of the door warden. Alright. A meditation chamber was spartan and strangely cold, seeming all the colder for the heartless flame which burned in the holy censer. The only bow that had been made to adornment in the temple, that had been made to adornment in the temple appeared to be the strange pattern that had been etched upon the wall. Alright, these are your fast travel. Yeah, you can see here, teleport. And the way it works is like... it'll probably explain it here. The design was odd. I see the mandala interests you. Turning, Locklear knows a thin young man standing on the archway, his hands hidden in the folds of his robe. While the relations between the temples and the new Academy of Magic at Stardock have been cool, it is one of the treasures they have passed on to the Sunari magic. It has given us great mobility. Mobility? Locklear asked. How can a painting help you move? The acolyte smiled. It'd be easier to explain by example. Tell me about a place you are familiar with, a place where you have spent a good deal of time. Locklear shrugged, describing the place he had grown up, the layout of the rooms, the various things associated with his home. Very good, the man replied. As you describe those things to me, doubtless you have experienced certain memories through which you were able to relive your past. In the same way, these mandalas help us locate a place. By memorizing a pattern painted on the wall of a specific temple, we may will ourselves there. I could think my way home with this. No. The memory of your home would be too unfocused for you to make the attempt. But if you were to memorize this pattern, you could return here by recalling its image in your mind when assisted by the power of another temple. Locklear looked back at the mandala, lost in thought for a moment, his eyes soaking up the intricacies of it. I assume there would be some fee associated with moving between locations. The acolyte nodded. As simple as it is in concept, it still requires a great deal of effort to move even a single individual, though I am told the Surani Great Ones move about with less effort. I believe Pug wished to restrict our knowledge of this in some ways until we had proven we would not abuse its power. I recognize his name, Pug. I think he's one of the major characters in the actual Riftwar novels. A bell sounded. Abruptly, a dark-robed priest swept into the room and came to a halt behind Locklear. I was alerted that you might desire to use the mandala. Desire, perhaps, but I haven't seen any of the other symbols, Locklear said. I don't suppose you could go with us? I regret that I cannot assist you, the priest said. My duties require that I stay here to guide others that wish to arrive. I'm sorry. Alright. Let's see, so what else do we have here? A look. The fire was cold. Unnerved by the unnatural flame, Locklear decided to explore elsewhere. Okay, so what is this? Alright, so this is just the same thing. Locklear pulled the curtains aside. The rear section of the temple was as dramatic as was the meditation chamber. A large pool occupied the center of the lush courtyard and was hemmed on all sides by an alabaster peristyle with climbing vines. Cloistered immediately off the open area were several arches, doorways either blocked by heavily woven curtains or choked with clouds of obscuring incense. Nearby a gong sounded, and immediately a priest hurried out of a doorway, halting as he caught sight of the unexpected supplicants. Alright, so this is our, healing, blessings, etc. Let's talk. Acolytes escorted them. After passing through a maddening series of arches, they finally were led into a large chamber, upon whose floor a seven-rayed star was formed in a mosaic by dark blue tiles. A small priest stood in the symbol's center, his back turned towards them. "We are looking for the high priest of this temple," Locklear said. "Would you know where we could find him?" "I am he." As the man half-turned, Locklear suppressed a gasp at the priest's hideous visage. Stuck to the left side of his face was a dark brown strip of cloth, a ragged hole torn in it to allow a pinkish-looking eye to peer out at them. "What is it you want?" he wheezed, his frame shuddering with each breath. "Are you new acolytes?" "No," Locklear swallowed with some difficulty. "We are travelers." "As all under the heavens are," the man said, making a feeble gesture at the vaulted ceiling above them. "All travelers. Please, let us talk a while." When at last many of the candles in the chamber had burned low, the priest nodded his head. "I've enjoyed this," he said quietly. "As have we," Locklear replied graciously, rising to leave. "Oh, before I forget, where was the interesting statue again you mentioned?"
"The Oracle, in the hills to the east of Malak's Cross."
Alright, I'm gonna, really quickly, I'm actually not in-game, you can see my mouse, I'm gonna open a notepad, and I'm gonna start taking some notes here. Alright. Oracle, in the hills to the east of Malak's Cross. Alright. The priest replied, "Perhaps your journeys will take you there soon." Alright, so we're done here, I think. The priest bid them farewell. Leaving the lushness of the central courtyard, they passed back through the curtains into the deserted meditation chamber. Man, it's been ages since I've actually had to take, like, notes in a game. How dare you require me to use my brain powers and, you know, write things. Okay, let's poke around. Is there anything hidden behind this place? I got to really quick. Change the rotation speed back to medium because, dang, it's horrible. Okay. Let's get back poking around here. Yeah, that is so much better. Alright, yeah, it doesn't look like there's anything back here. Go minimap for showing that to me. Like, on the back of the box for this game, let me pull it up here, like, let me grab it, I should say. It says that there are, like, explore 224 million square feet of forested trails, snow-covered mountain ranges, maze-like sewers, and bustling towns. It's crazy. Just freaking crazy. So, there's a lot of game here and a lot of exploration to be done. Alright, and it looks like we have another town. Please have a shop I can actually sell things at. Luckily, I knocked on the door. Doesn't seem anybody about. Okay, what about this one? Another tavern? Nope. Nobody about. What about this one? The house occupant was talkative. Careful not to divulge any details about their trip. Luckily, I steered the conversation towards the townspeople. Everyone here is fine folks, all except for Michelle the healer. I hope you're not planning to visit her. Why? Luckily, I asked. Oh, she's a snake, he said. Told me I was going to die, but you know what? I got better. Though I felt horrible enough for 3 or 4 days and thought I was going to die, but no, I made it through alive, I tell you. I think she and Orn are the pale of some kind of deal. He's giving them some kind of contagion, and then she's administering some kind of phony medicine. It's indecent. Really? Noting that down. Michelle the healer. Possibly disseminating contagion. Good to know. Alright. What is this? A thin little man greeted them at the door. I'm Kiefer Ale's cook. Have you come to buy or sell some gems? He questioned in a frail voice. Luckily, we moved closer to the door. We're looking for a ruby that may have been stolen by a group of gray warriors. Have you purchased any gemstones from such men? I don't know what you're talking about, the man said quickly. I don't buy stolen merchandise. You might try talking to a fellow I ran into north of Hawk's Hollow. Oh, here we go. Alright. Stolen ruby. Look for Isaac north of Hawk's Hollow. Nice. The man looked about nervously. I'm not open for business right now. You'll have to come back later. Before Locklear could say another word, Kiefer had closed the door. Who names their kid Kiefer? Who does that? Hey, door, how you doing? Bell rang. All right, shopkeeper. Kingdom Goods, the lay of the goods store was comfortably familiar, arranged in such common sense fashion that it took only a few moments for Locklear to locate the items which interested him. Looks like they got weapons and armor. Yes, you do, you beautiful bastards. All right. Which means you're willing to buy this. A sovereign, sure. Yeah, okay, so their quality is, in fact, indicative of their value. I don't think I didn't see that two-handed sword in there. That is tempting to me. Alright, so his sword is at 52, so I'm actually going to sell it. Luckily, aside from money, he thought he'd discard his broadsword, his bulk wearisome for him to bear, and its value seemingly more dubious than when he'd acquired it. In the balance, however, he realized it'd be utter madness to strip himself of his defenses at a time when he needed them most. Well, here, then, equip this one. There, and now sell it. It's not like we don't have more swords, we're rolling in them. Alright, so sell this, yes. How's everybody's armor looking? Give this 92 to Locklear. I could be repairing these with like my repair hammers and stuff, but I don't know if like a charge of air hammer is worth, repair hammer is worth what we'd be getting. So that'll go there. We'll sell this. You can equip that one. You can sell this. I'm gonna sell this thing. I'm not gonna use it. I have no use for such an item. Ha, it's elven make. I wouldn't buy it either. Okay, two-handed broadsword. Lacking the sharpened, drooping quillions of a more basic kingdom broadsword, the two-handed variety had much to recommend itself. Heavier than a simple broadsword, the two-handed variety was broader bladed and therefore more likely to hit and harm its intended target. Sadly, they won't let me look at more detailed information about it. This guy sells rations, too. Earl packs, ale casks. Curiosity sufficiently piqued, Locklear popped open the half-gallon cask and inhaled deeply. Immediately, his senses reeled as the heady cinnamon-like aroma assaulted him. Cashian ale! Alright. We have some torches. I don't think we have many. We have 12. Okay, so I think that should suffice on us for torches. Do you have any healing items? No. You just have a bunch of broadswords. Clerical oilcloth, aventurine, strategies in trading. I can't even afford it. I want it so bad, though. Let's see, how are we looking on? No. I want to see food. We are set for food. All right, we're going to get out of here. Doesn't have anything else that I really need, I don't think. And we have lightened our load sufficiently. You've been more than generous. All right, so just a little flavor text there. Up here, luckily you're knocked on the door for a long moment. Doesn't seem to be anybody around. Also doesn't seem to be anybody around. Okay, so we're headed south, I believe. Okay, so it looks like our next town. We're actually, I don't think, going to go to Hawks Hollow. We're gonna go kind of around and down here, I guess. Or I mean, I could cut towards the woods. We'll cut towards the woods and see if there's anything fun down there. His famous last words before horrible death, I'm sure. See, can I just ambush one of you guys? Oh, wow, there are a bunch of you out here. Holy crap. Alright, I'll fight like one of you at a time, but I don't want to necessarily fight like three of you at once. Okay, how many did we get? Oh, sadness. All right, like the reason I didn't want to do this is because we're already kind of beat up from the last fight. Like Locklear in particular is like sitting at 13. I think Goreth has like 15. No, Goreth's at like full health. Screw that. Goreth, do your job, tank. Come on, you guys, like hit. It's not that hard. You're gonna have to sleep for like a month. I hate you, Locklear. Owen just got hit for, I think, like 20 points of damage. Yeah, Owen's hurting. Let's run him back into a corner. Seriously, oh, that was a poor choice on my part. It'd be great if anybody could hit these guys. These are seemingly pretty badass. It's just like it's like first edition D&D right here. It's just miss, 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 miss until somebody gets hit once and then everybody dies. It's great. Oh, Owen, you are just getting the hell beaten out of you right now. These guys are no joke. You got 6 hit points left. No, what is this? Cause the character to rest for one round. What is this? Resting. I don't know what this is actually gonna do. I hope it saves you, Owen. That's one down. Nope, Owen goes down. Crap. Thanks, Locklear. Friggin' flurry of misses over here. That's okay. Like I said, we're just gonna camp after this anyways. We'll give him some healing potions and prayer. Okay, maybe these guys will have some curatives on them or something. Damn! Some nasty suckers! It's partially because I'm missing all the time. Like, that's, like, ridiculous how often we're missing. We've been doing good, too! This guy's just parrying everything. If he's defending or something. Come on, guys. There he goes. All right. A gasp escaped Owen's lips as he levered himself into an upright position. I think I'll amend the pain, he said. My wounds are mortal. You can go on without me. No one gets locked behind. Yeah, it's the same thing. All right. The party's abilities have increased. Okay, I assume that means skills have increased on more than one character. So let's go ahead and give these all to Owen. Dude, you need to heal yourself. I'm just gonna get him like to there, because we got 3 left. All right. Let us loot the bodies. Some money, nice. Some armor, some weapons. No, the corpse, there we go. Okay, second guy. Oh, a whetstone, nice. Let's see, how are these spoiled? Not enough room. Goreth scowls. That doesn't surprise me. He seems one to scowl a lot. Okay, now where's the third guy at? I know he's with this mound. I just gotta find him among them. Maybe. There we go. Is that him? Yes. Okay. How are these? Spoiled. All right. Good times. Good times. Owen, you're terrible. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Some serious... God damn. Some serious food consumption going on there. I assume that's probably because he's near death. Yeah. He'll heal better once he's no longer completely boned. Here, drink all of those. How are you looking now, Owen? Still near death. Alright, well, we're gonna pull it back to town. We need food now. Okay, just sleep until, like, midday. I guess I'm not too interested in doing business right now. Alright, was this the shop? Nope. Where was the shop? There we go. Okay, well, I mean, upside is that I can sell stuff. More stuff, I should say. And just use the money from that to pay for food. So it's not like we really have lost... I didn't say we haven't lost income, because we have. We've lost those healing potions. But the setback is only temporary. I suppose you buy the... Eh, we'll hold on the crossbow quarrels for the time being. Alright. Rations. Accept. Give him 14. Rations. Accept. Give him 14. Yeah, I think we lost, like, what, 4 sovereigns worth of stuff? I think we had 113 before I sold stuff. So that's not anything I'm gonna whinge about. Considering we've had to spend so long sleeping to heal someone. Alright, so let's go ahead and repair stuff where we can. Give you a whetstone too. Can I do more? No. Okay. Just checking. Alright, let's rest. Come on, Owen. Don't take another month. There we go. That's what I like to see. Some nice quick healing. Alright, but yeah, those guys were nasty. Like, decidedly more so than the last group we fought. And their corpses are still there. Good. You can rot. Okay. Let's kind of poke around a little bit here. Well, let's see. We know... Like, damn. We know now that, like, I previously was not talking about going to Hawk's Hollow right here. However, now that we know that the stolen ruby, there's someone there named, like, around there named Isaac, north of Hawk's Hollow, that might be something that we want to poke around with. So, I mean, I suppose I have no objection to poking around in side quests. Like, I'm sure this game has a substantial number of them. And I'm certainly not going to do all of them, but I'm not opposed to doing, you know, one every so often here. What does this lead to? Just, oh, a random house back here. Okay. No one answered. Luckily, they just persisted in knocking. Alright, so that's somebody just in there napping. So we'll wait until morning. Hey, piece of paper dangled from the doorknob. At all costs, travelers should avoid contact with Orno, widely known as Orno the Pale, Owen read aloud. Contagion of unknown proportions has already led to the illness of 3 people. Avoid any contact with... The door swung open. Him. Owen strained himself as a haggard-looking man in his mid-20s appeared in the doorway, his face covered with a bloody handkerchief. You're Orno.
Yes, he wheezed through his handkerchief. And you are on my doorstep. Get away before you get yourselves infected.
What's wrong with you? The man shook his head.
Don't know. Doctors don't know. Priests don't know. Nobody knows. Only person that survived is Michelle, a healer. But she's a ways off in L'Oreal.
I see, Locklear said. Well, we'll be off now. Sorry to have bothered you. Again, the man nodded.
I sure you will be. I sure of it.
Okay. Well, I'm going to note down that Michelle, the healer, is in L'Oreal. Alright. No one wished to speak about it. Seeing the glazed look in each other's eyes and sickly pallor each had begun to exhibit, ah, it was more than obvious they had fallen prey to a villain plague. Silently, Locklear hoped they could reach a temple soon before they all died of it. Oh, that's great. Damn it, Gorath. All right. Well, that's okay. We can just go back north. Flip the map back on, and we'll just walk. I'm trying to remember where this thing was. I know it was north, and it's not like there's, you know, a lot of... random side areas or anything here. Seems pretty straightforward. All right, here's the temple. Oh, I pity my coin purse. Hey, temple. We are back. We want cure. Require many hours of our time, and even priests must find ways to pay for their needs. For your condition, we will need many oils and candles, 16 sovereigns and 5 royals. Oh, that's not bad. All right. Cure player. Locklear sat up. Looking around the room, he blinked at the haggard-looking healer priest who was propped up in a corner. Dimly, he recalled the events of the grueling hours which had passed. Hours in which he had thrashed on the bed as clerics chanted over him. Other times in which he lapsed into fevered dreams filled with nightmarish creatures. You're free of your demons, the priest said with a weak smile. His voice was gravelly from exertion. It was a tough battle, but you are well enough as you are. You may go. Okay. Same thing. 24 sovereigns. Oh, wow. Gorath was really far along there. Alright, so that right there, that cost us some money. That hurt our finances a little bit. I think we're probably down to, like, what, about 60 royals? Fucking 48 sovereigns, rather. Curse you, game, and punishing me for deigning to look into every little nook and cranny. I mean, we were warned about there being a plague going around, so I can't really, I guess, whinge too much about it. Alright, well, now we know that house is bad. So we are sitting back here about where we were. It is the middle of the night. Might as well. Oh, wow, that actually, shit. That did some harrowing amounts of damage to us there. Noted. Okay. A pebble tumbled down the cliff face. Uh-oh. Puzzled by this seemingly random event, Owen glanced upwards, then back down at the ground. On a closer examination, he realized the pebble was in fact a very dull brass button. Before he could cry out, ambushers fell from above. And by ambushers, they meant one guy who chose very poorly in attacking the party with a spellcaster capable of paralytic magic. Oh, buddy. So I know that our staminas aren't, I don't think, maxed out, like... Yeah, I wonder if that, like, goes down because we haven't slept, maybe. I don't know. Alright, Owen, you just... Oh, okay, so doing this heals you a little bit. He got 2 stamina back for doing that. Which is interesting, that means he could basically, like, against a single target like this, he can blind the guy indefinitely, because he can spend one round blinding him, then the next round healing him, or healing his stamina, and then blind the guy again. Except for when they save like that, obviously. Good to know, though. I mean, like, that keeps it so you can kind of do, like, minor magic, I guess, without too much issue. Spare thy eyes. Where's my fireballs? Down he goes. The battle was won. Search the body for supplies. All right. Let's have a look-see here. I think he only made it worse. What is this? Elven armor. Starting with its complicated elven buckles, Gorath tried the breastplate on for size. Too wide for him at the shoulders, he was nevertheless pleased with its clever filigrees and fine fluted scrollwork. Patterns designed to be decorative while also denying enemies an even striking plane. Huh. Alright, we're gonna take that. That might actually be an upgrade for him. Let's see, I think you have the quarrels. And we'll take the sword. Alright, let's have a look-see here. Let's compare some numbers. Armor mod 15, armor mod 25, and requires elf, which he is an elf, so... Bam! Upgrade! And... Haha, up to 96. How's yours looking? 76? 86, alright, better. Okay. Grass abilities have increased. Sweet. But yeah, it's like... Oh, okay, I see what it is. It, like, you can only... you can only camp up to a certain point. That's because we're camping outside. That I knew that. If you rest in an inn, it will let you rest to full health, but resting out in like the wilderness like this, you can't. And that's why, for example, you'd want to camp in like an abandoned house or something, I believe, because that would let you get some additional health that you wouldn't otherwise get. Okay. Oh, that's trouble. Couple guys over there don't necessarily want to be mixing it up with them. Bird shot into the sky. Searching the landscape for the source of the animal's discomfort, Gorath whispered. Ah, yeah. Pay attention to that little creature. Whatever startled it may be close at hand. If we continue the distraction we are currently headed, I suggest we do so with great caution. Swell voice. It's so... Oh my god, seriously? We may have one. Oh, another trap. Okay. So we just gotta walk through the center then? That's not too bad. Well, first though, let's use it now. Do invitation. Let's see if I can pull this guy. There we go. Get him nice in our faces so that we can cut him down. Guys. Well, I thought he was just kind of standing there. Oh, it's because he's a spellcaster, and for whatever reason, the AI has pro-cammed him. I love it. He's a spellcaster, but he's not going to fight back. I see. I think we want to go through just the center here. So, let's see if... Yeah. Battle was won. All right, that wasn't too bad as far as horrible death trap combats go. Oh, we got some more healing restoratives. Nice. And 20 sovereigns. Also nice. Whoa, hey there. So we can apparently click on our money there to look at our funds. Noted. Okay, and we are at 32 minutes. However, I think I'm going to go for a couple more here. I'm having a good time with this. Okay, so I'm going to go. And we're just going to follow the road for the time being here. Like I said, I want to go off the road, but I'm going to spend, you know, years just wandering around getting lost, because that's what I do in these games. See, and like I said, I'm sure I'm missing things. Okay, I want to see where we are relative to Hawk's Hollow. All right, that's the thing. It's like we've gone past Hawk's Hollow. Let's turn around, freaking jackass. Gorath stopped and bent down to examine something on the ground. After several seconds, he stood and began to speak.
There are wagon tracks on the ground here, but something's not right. They look fairly old, but the marks are too thin. Ordinary wagon wheels are about, say, 6 inches. These couldn't be wider than 3. There could be an ambush ahead. If we proceed in the direction we are currently heading, we should do so with great caution.
Yay, you go, Gorath. Teaching the party stuff. Yeah, a pebble tumbled down the cliff face before he could cry out. Ambushers fell from above. Ambusher fell from above. Ambusher getting his eyes despaired. Everybody else is charging in to stab the god out of him. Hey there, buddy. Welcome to melee damage. Oh, come on now. There we go. That was easy. I think I did not see that one coming. Okay. Wow, a 91 quality sword and a bunch of rations. That pleases me greatly. We might as well... Ah, not enough room. I say we're gonna leave this behind, but it's like we've got room, so we might as well take it, I guess. Okay, so I want to go essentially west, but... So that's gonna take me... Yeah, that's the way I don't want to go. We want to go this way. Find Hawk's Hollow. I would like to tentatively be able to end the episode in Hawk's Hollow. Okay, so it looks like it is just due southwest of us. So like in this general direction here. It's probably not wise to be exploring like this because I'm like gonna blunder into something like an attack or I'll miss like a chest or something, but it is what it is. All right. The inn, yes, largely chartered by the local lord to ensure the safety of travelers. However, it would also mean the inn's furnishings would be suitable. The dusty dwarf, except for the thin strip of floor, Jesus, led between the door, the counter, and the stairs, a great cowl of dust coated the inn's fixtures. The patrons seemed strangely stagnant as they glanced up leisurely from their mugs of ale and brandy. Okay, oh yeah, we could do some barding. Owen struggled with the lute. Yeah, as soon as he'd begun to play, he felt he was not so much playing a song as he was wrestling a beast 100 times his size. Numerous times the song eluded him, slipped out of his reach only to fall into an obscure pit of noise. Out, 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 the tavern keeper urged, yanking the lute from his hands. Be glad this crowd isn't in a worse mood. Give them time to calm down and you can come back, but only if you're coming back for food. That's great. So does that mean, like, I literally can't sleep here now? I don't know. Let's talk to some people. The man scowled, apparently far more intent on something going on across the common room. He seemed uninterested in Locklear's repeated attempts to chat. At last, he glanced up and gave an exasperated sigh. What exactly do you want? Not just a little friendly talk, Locklear said with a companionable smile. News, gossip, a song, perhaps?
Well, go and find a bloody jongler and leave me alone. I've got better things to do than entertain every jackaboot that comes through that door.
All right, so that guy's a jerk. What about you? Locklear tapped the woman's shoulder. Slowly, she turned to look at him, but rather than greeting him with a smile, in her gaze was a look that he had thought reserved only for things that crawled on the ground or lapped up table leavings in the dooryard. What do you want? I was hoping perhaps we could talk, Locklear ventured. Pass the time with a little conversation. Why? She said curtly, opening his mouth to reply, but suddenly finding himself bereft of adequate speech, he made a small sound which he was certain sounded quite unmanly. Stabbing him with her exquisite, beautiful stare, she smiled. I thought as much. Goodbye, sir. I'm sure you have a brilliant oratory career before you. That's great. So I assume this is just food and stuff, which I think we're okay on. I want a knight here, though. Seven sovereigns for the knight, he grumbled. You lost my beds, I'll charge you double. Sure. Room's upstairs. Have a good rest. Alright, the room was cramped. Shrugging, Owen stepped over snoring bodies and selected a spot of floor which looked like it might be comfortable for the night. Agora squeezed into a bed already occupied by 3 disheveled-looking men.
Ah, the romance of traveling, Owen said with a chuckle.
Luckily, he drummed his fingers on the counter after a brief wait the Nightmaster and entered whistling a cheerful look on his face. So, gents, you have a good night. Excellent, Locklear intoned with false sincerity. I don't know when I had a better sleep. That was, of course, when I could get to sleep. What are you doing down here, skinning cats? Deep blush spread across the innkeeper's face. I had company. It's been a while, he said sheepishly. You can't hold that against a fellow now, can you? So, can I sign you up for another night? Yeah, one more. Rooms upstairs, have a good rest. There we go. Alright, so we are basically topped off now, I think, on health. And we are in what I believe is Hawk's Hollow. So, next time, we will ideally start searching for the stolen ruby. So, I'm calling it. As per usual, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I will catch you all next time when the adventure continues. Until then, and maybe I'll even remember to save while I'm actually playing the game. Who knows? Take it easy.